This is Teacher Jonna, and welcome to our online class for our Christian Living or Bible subject. And I hope everyone is okay and safe in their homes. So please stay at home. Don't go out. Okay? Our lesson for today is entitled Prayer Answered. Later, after class, you can also check your books. Read everything. You can read the lesson on pages 85-87 on your Christian Living books. But right after our class. Okay? And before we start, I would like you to get a pen and paper with you. Please do, or your notebooks, Bible notebooks, and a pen. Okay? Please take down notes about everything that we will discuss today because we will have a short online quiz. Yay! Alright? Okay. Let's have our opening prayer. Lord, we thank you for this day that we have an opportunity to learn still, despite of this crisis. Thank you, Lord, for protecting each and every one of us. Lord, give us wisdom and understanding and help us to learn about prayer and about prayer that will be answered. Thank you, Father, and bless each and every one of us. Reveal yourself to us, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Alright, our lesson is about a story from Daniel chapter 2. And I prepared a short video. So watch carefully, okay? And write down important facts in the story. Because, again, we will have a short quiz right after. Okay, are you ready? Everyone is ready? Okay, here we go.
Two years after rising to the throne of Babylon, King Nebuchadnezzar had a terrible dream. This dream frightened him so much that he couldn't sleep. King Nebuchadnezzar, in anguish and desperate to learn what the dream meant, called in all the wise men known to him to see if any of them could interpret his dream. The wise men came before King Nebuchadnezzar and asked him to tell them about his dream, but the king refused. King Nebuchadnezzar demanded that the wise men first tell him what he dreamed, and then what the dream meant. The king declared, "If you can do this, I will give you great rewards. If not, I will have you put to death." In disbelief of the king's request, the wise men said, "King Nebuchadnezzar, what you ask is impossible. No one can do what you ask. Only a god could tell you your dream." This made King Nebuchadnezzar so angry that he ordered that all his wise men be put to death, including Daniel and his friends Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. When the king's chief soldier, Arioch, came to capture Daniel, he asked Arioch what was going on. Arioch explained the situation, and Daniel went to King Nebuchadnezzar to ask for time to interpret the dream. The king agreed, and Daniel hurried back to see Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego so that they could pray for God's help. That night, God revealed to Daniel the king's dream and its meaning. The next morning, Daniel went to Arioch and said, "Don't execute the wise men of Babylon. I will interpret the king's dream." When Arioch brought Daniel before King Nebuchadnezzar, the troubled, tired king asked Daniel, "Can you tell me what I saw in my dream?" Daniel replied, "No one could tell you this, but there is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries. He showed me your dream and what it means." Daniel told the king, God showed you the future through your dream. In your dream, you saw a statue with a head of gold, chest and arms of silver, belly and thighs of bronze, legs of iron, and feet of iron mixed with clay. Then a rock smashed the statue. The rock became a mountain that filled the whole earth. You, King, are the head of gold, and every other part of the statue are the kingdoms that will come after you. The rock represents a kingdom that God will establish that will last forever. King Nebuchadnezzar bowed before Daniel and showed him great honor for all that God had spoken through him. The king said, "Surely your God is the God of gods and the Lord of kings, the one who can reveal the greatest of mysteries." For his service, King Nebuchadnezzar promoted Daniel to a high position and placed him in charge of all the wise men. At Daniel's request, the king also promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to rule over all the provinces of Babylon.
What a beautiful story, right? And with that, let's have our short quiz. Yes, we will have our short quiz. Now, I want you to write down your answers on a piece of paper or on your Bible notebooks. Then, for each question, you can pause this video so you can answer. Okay, and then after our quiz, send me your answers directly via Messenger. Okay? Alright, so everybody's ready? First question. Who are the characters of the story? Again, who are the characters of the story? Right, question number two. Ready? Who was the king who had a dream that worries him so bad? Who was the king who had a dream that worries him so bad? And what did he demanded from the wise man? What did he order from his wise men about the dream? Okay, question number three. What are the names of Daniel's friends? What are the names of Daniel's friends? And what did they do when they heard the news? Give me the names of Daniel's friends, and then what did they do when they heard the news? Question number four. What was the dream all about? And what does it mean? According to Daniel. Again, what was the dream all about? And what does it mean? I will check your answers and record your scores. And I will update you about the quiz. Going back to our story. So, what is the lesson behind it? The story tells us that prayer is powerful. This tells us that if there's confusion, pray to God. If we are experiencing problems, we have to pray. And if we can't sleep, pray and pray and pray. Lesson number one, the best thing about prayer is that every prayer has an answer. Remember this, God answers prayers. In the story, Daniel asked his friends to pray with him. One of the best ways to pray is having someone or having your friends or your families with you who will agree with you in prayer. Because in Matthew 18, verses 19 to 20, Jesus said, whenever two or of you on earth agree about anything you pray for, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three come together in my name, I am there with them. Whose name? Jesus. That's why we say in Jesus' name in every prayer. Also, Jesus said that He is with us every time that we pray together. And that is a promise. Lesson number two. If you receive the answer, God already answered your prayer, let's praise and thank God for it. In the story, the confused king prays and thanked God of Daniel and his friends when he finally understood his dream. Now, I want you to remember your prayers that you've prayed before that has been answered already by God. Write it down and send it to me also, okay? Write down the things that you are thankful for because God answered your prayers, okay? For your homework, I would like you to group yourselves into three, okay? Create a group chat including me. Then, we will set a time for each group for us to video call. And then, you'll pray for the following, okay? We need to pray for our nation. We are going to pray for our family. And then, we will pray for your groupmates. Okay? And I hope that you've learned something today and apply it to our daily lives. Let's close in prayer. Lord, thank you for our learnings today. And help us, Lord, to pray and pray and pray every day. Because, Lord, you answer prayers. You listen to our prayers. And you said, Lord, in your word that two or three gathered in your name, you are with them. Thank you, Lord, for being with us all the time. And we praise you and we thank you, Lord, for all the things you have done and what you are going to do. Glorify you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.